right? He called Adam, right?
Right.
He didn't say Adam preached, he just called Adam into existence. Mm-hmm. And Adam became who God called him to be.
Right.
Right?
Right.
And notice that science used the word ATOM, which is the DNA factor of everything, right? So he called Adam, and then he called Eve, and, but they never talked about everything that came before after Adam and Eve, you know, when they started doing the creation. But he began to speak these things, and things began to take place, and we began to look and we began to ask the question, if I come out of religion into a relationship with God, what would that look like? Because it says that if God called me from the foundation of the earth, isn't that what it said in Joshua? I believe in Joshua. It said, before I formed you in the belly of your mother's belly, I knew you. I called you. And then it also said the same thing in Ephesians. The same thing. Before I knew you, I formed you. I called you. I knew your name. I knew you before your mother, your father, your grandmother. I knew you before any of the bloodlines were existing. I ordained you to be in such a time as this. But we find ourselves dying prematurely, either mentally, physically, or spiritually, because we don't have a relationship with God. And by us not having a relationship with God, we don't know who we are. As we started off with the session, I said, I wore so many masks that I didn't know who I was. My identity was all over the place. So it made me feel myself getting insecure when I placed, because I didn't prepare myself for certain relationships. So by me not preparing myself for certain relationships, or expecting myself to be able to be this person or be this person in this relationship, I became someone in a relationship that kind of crippled things. So anyway, God called me to be who I am, he created me from the foundation of the earth, he knew me before he knew my mother, he knew me in the womb, and greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world, and my body's the temple of the Holy Ghost, then I need to know how to speak to my body. I need to know how to speak to my different situation, and the only way I can do that is by the renewing of my mind. I have to change the things I allow into my mind. I can't be controlling or possessive of anybody's life. I have to focus on my life. Because at the end of the day, no matter what Jacob does, growing up to the day he go on and I go on, I won't be too much held. Only time I'll be held accountable for certain parts of his life is in the training and rearing him up till he gets to the age of accountability. Outside of that, once he becomes a grown person, I'm not held accountable for that. According to life, in the natural as well as in the spiritual, they both mimic each other. Both are governed by rules, regulations, and what? Laws. So if that's the case, then in the natural, ignorant of the law is no excuse, right? In the spiritual, the same thing. Either you pay attention to me now or you ignore me, but you're still held accountable for everything that's said. From right here. So you can ignore me, you can be in the la-la land, you can be ignoring me, but then when they play back your life, you're going to see this, and God said, I told you, pay attention, because this is what you needed for that day, and you came to me, you kept praying, God, why me, why me? And he said, because you ignored this message I gave you. So we have to stop being easily distracted. Amen?